Welcome to the channel. Welcome to another video. Today we're talking Fast, talking Furious, talking a non-spoiler review of Fast 9. So let's go. It's finally been released. It's finally here. So what do I think? Well, we'll get to that. But first, as Fast 9 was just released, there is the possibility that new viewers might be watching this video. If so, again, welcome to the channel. This channel is dedicated to the Fast and Furious franchise, though I sometimes dabble in Marvel. I release a video every Thursday, so please consider subscribing so you hear everything I have to say about Fast and Furious. So what did I think about it? Number one thing, it was better than Fast 8. See my review of Fast 8 for more, as they make some major mistakes in that one. And I can say that they did better in Fast 9 for sure. To see that they had gotten the franchise turned around after Fast 8 was my number one priority going in, and that was delivered. In my Fast 8 review, I voiced three major issues: that the characters' motivations are backwards from the normal, that the team has no agency and no actual control or influence over anything that happens, and that the writing betrayed the characters they had built up over the course of previous movies. In Fast 9, they did better on two of these three points. One was properly made right, another was a good attempt, but the other, they made that mistake all over again. I'll discuss more in my full review, but this is good progress, definitely better than Fast 8. That being said, it's too long. It's boring in a few places. There's too much exposition, one huge exposition dump. I'm sure you can guess what that was about. Also, the writing went overboard, tying stuff from previous movies to the plot. This was too heavy-handed. It's not only clunky, but shows they're trying too hard to give this movie a connection to the franchise. Due to this, the movie seemed insular. Some positives. As I've said, they got back to their bread and butter on a few things missing in Fast 8, but also, the action sees a return to practical stunts. My major issue with Furious 7 was with the ending, because of the overuse of CGI. They've gotten the message because this movie fixes that. They are relying on practical effects greatly. I'm sure they use CGI to supplement everything, but the stunts are great, except for one part where it was definitely not practical. If you've seen all the trailers, you can probably guess what I'm talking about. There is a bit of self-parody in this movie. Some elements are taken to an extreme, making it clear the writers are self-aware about what they're doing, which is a good thing, to know that they know they aren't Marvel. This movie's pace starts off fast, and except for some clunky exposition dumps, it's just action after action. This is good and bad. I believe heavily in the lull in the middle of Fast and Furious movies, where the team has time to plan, reflect, and get pieces of a plan taken care of. This movie comes up short on that, but as a result, you can't say that it's boring for lack of action. It's tons of action. I was bored at certain points, but only because I was 99% sure that the action I was seeing meant nothing. They could have shortened this movie, spent more time on characters in Act 1 before getting into the super spy stuff, guns and explosions, and had a better movie. It's not a spoiler to say the movie had action, but it would be a spoiler to describe something else it had. But if you see the movie, this will be obvious, so go check it out. But the movie was trying to do something with a couple of the characters that a movie can't do unless it really commits to it. This movie tried to commit to this by using a long runtime rather than committing to it thematically. If they had done this properly, Fast 9 could have been the most emotionally meaningful Fast and Furious movie ever, by far. I really felt some things in certain scenes, but they needed to have taken their time and planted more seeds for that to grow. Instead, they just watered the few scraggly seeds they had with high-octane gasoline and NOS and hoped the audience would do the rest. And we as the audience and fans can do the rest when it comes to three-foot dolly shots and mega-action set pieces, but we can't when it comes to what they were kind of trying to do in this movie. The escalating action size and plot outrageousness index that they apparently believe they have to keep up with really got in the way of this movie connecting. They left a lot on the table. After getting some reveals from the trailers, I wanted more and expected to get it, but instead, all I got was a new level and far-fetched action scenes. But overall, it's good enough. It's unfair to compare it to Fast 5 and Fast 6, the classics. It's on par with Furious 7 though, but I feel Furious 7 came close to its potential, whereas Fast 9 fell far short of its own. Please go see the movie and come back for my full review of Fast 9. It'll be out on Thursday. For now, keep it fast and keep it furious.
We heard y'all needed a little love out here.